Hey, man, A Boogie and his whole crew just jumped me in the back, man, and beat me up in the back, man. That shit crazy, man. Hey, but I'm going to tell y'all like this. It's all love. I don't promote violence. I'm never with the violence. So I love him, and it's all good.
Hey, everyone. A very disappointed Anthony Fantano here, the internet's busiest music nerd here. Lil B the Bass God himself at the Rolling Loud Festival, according to him, and I saw some kind of spotty video on Twitter of this as well. I couldn't exactly tell where Lil B was in that video, if in fact the video was sort of actually footage of the event. Information and everything about this is unfolding currently. I've seen some people say that even PNB Rock may be involved with this, but I don't know that to be the case. That's just sort of online hearsay. What I've seen reported so far and what I have seen from this video and, you know, pretty much every clip of every angle, Lil B talking in front of everybody at the festival. A Boogie with the Hoodie, 2017 XXL freshman, who I believe had, in my opinion, one of the better freestyle performances, if I remember correctly. Or was it? I think it was one of the better cyphers, rather. But I can't recall off the top of my head. But Lil B says that Boogie and his crew jumped him, and according to Lil B, it was because Boogie and his crew or whatever didn't care for B's opinion of his music. And who knows, maybe it could have been a little bit more than that, you know, because we haven't heard both sides of the story at this point. However, at this point, I am, you know, going to believe the Bass God. I'm going to side with the Bass God here because, you know, there's nothing really that I think he could have said that would actually warrant sort of physical violence toward him, you know, especially if it's an opinion on Boogie's music. Excuse me, by the way, I just like came in from a run and, you know, I'm a little unhappy about all this. You know, it's dark out and I'm tired and I'm really thirsty. But I'm kind of ticked about this right now. Lil B does not deserve the violence. Lil B does not deserve to be hurt. Protect the Bass God at all costs. this is gross. This is disgusting. And if events went down the way that Lil B says they went down, then honestly, at the end of the day, this is another sort of instance of people just not being able to take an opinion. And take it from the guy who puts out opinions for a living and deals with the fact that people cannot take an opinion every day of his life. And there are some people who seriously like get wild because they don't like what you said about their music, or they don't like that you don't like their music, or da 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 da. It's crazy what people will do to you or try to do to you over your opinion or over a joke or over you know, your point of view of a situation. And Lil B, unfortunately, is a victim of that. Now, of course, if you guys remember, this is not the first time he's sort of been, you know, jumped or been sort of attacked while he was off guard, you know, attacked when he wasn't expecting it. I'm glad that he has pulled through this time as well. And it looks like Lil B is taking the high road here and is saying that, you know, he's not retaliating here. He's pushing positivity. He's not pushing violence. And honestly, like, that is the Lil B we know. That is the Lil B we love. That is the Lil B we like to see. Because at the end of the day, you know, this is going to be a seriously, like, bad PR move for Boogie, who, honestly, while he does have a lot of the traditional, you know, sort of very commercial side of the industry pushing him right now, you know, he's got a lot of radio play. His new album, which I have not covered yet, it's very generic. It's very run-of-the-mill. It's very focus grouped. He really bites his most mainstream contemporaries really hard to the point where there's not too much special about his music, but there is potential there. You know, that side of the industry certainly has his back, but I mean, if you go at Lil B, I mean, Lil B is like, you know, the grandfather, or rather the father, to a lot of artists in this new wave of rappers. A lot of artists, especially these mumble rap kids. And to go at this dude who is your, you know, like your like genetically on a music level, you know, your predecessor, this guy who so many people in the industry wouldn't be here right now if not for this dude, to go at him physically, you know, not even say, oh, Little B's washed up, Little B's old, you know, you just go at him with an opinion. I mean, that alone would get you in trouble. That alone would turn a lot of people against you. But to actually attack the man physically is like seriously beyond the pale, not just, you know, because it was violence, you know, but because, you know, you're going at a legend here. You're going at an icon, you know, an internet rap icon, a guy who, in my opinion, is hip hop's first major and significant outsider artist. Yeah, it's gross. And personally, I'm disappointed, although I am happy that I have not gotten around and I have not made the time or the effort to review Boogie's new album, because I'm sure not going to do it now. After this, because this is gross, and I do not support this, and that's really nasty for an artist to attack another artist so blatantly and just over an opinion. It's just not acceptable. It's not cool. And I just thought I would make a statement about that here, express my opinion. You guys hit me up in the comments. Let me know what you think. Are you disgusted by this as me? Because on top of this attack, we also have an element of robbery here as well, because Little B couldn't do his set, because Little B is saying that Boogie and his crew took his shit. So he couldn't even do his set. And Little B's looking great over here in the khaki suit with the braids. He's looking amazing. He's looking effervescent. And he can't even perform for this crowd of people, many of whom may have paid to just see him. So, you know, you're not only attacking the bass god here, you know, but you're screwing over a lot of concert goers too. Now, you know, I think this is, again, Little B's going to come out of this bigger than ever. This is going to be a rallying cry for him. You know, truth be told, the bass god has not been quite as hot and quite as viral as he has been in the past. You know, not dropping as many mixtapes, not dropping as many music videos, and that's fine. You know, he's made the mark on the music industry that he needs to make. You know, he doesn't owe us anything else. He's changed things greatly already. You know, if he keeps coming out with music, if he keeps coming out with videos, that's great. That's fantastic. You know, but he doesn't owe us anything else. He's already changed the landscape as it is. So, you know, the fact that he's still out here, the fact that he's still, you know, doing what he's doing is great. It's amazing. And it just sucks that you have these dudes that don't know how to take an opinion. They don't know how to act rationally. They don't know how to control themselves. And they lash out at a legend like Little B. Even if Little B disrespected you to your face, even if he did, you know, honestly, it's you may not like it. But, you know, like the position that he's in, you don't physically attack the guy. It's not right. And it's only going to come back on you and look bad. Because Little B, if you know anything about Little B, this is what he was going to do. He wasn't going to attack you back. He wasn't going to put you down. He was going to use the situation to lift other people up. And that's what he's doing. It's a smart move. It's taking the high road. This is why Little B is in the position that he's in. And this is why in a few years, nobody's going to care about a Boogie with a hoodie. All right, over here next to my head is another video that you should check out, or you can click on the link to subscribe to the channel. I'll catch you guys in the next one forever.